like to welcome all of you here for this special wedding luncheon, celebrating the wedding today of Jamie and Ben. And we're excited. It's been a wonderful day so far, and this is a great occasion to be together and to celebrate them and their commitment to each other and to enjoy a meal and the program together. Before we begin, I just want to mention that for those of you who have smaller children, there are some high chairs and booster chairs that are right over here. And we also, at the door, somewhere near the door, there is a guest book if you haven't signed in yet. And there are also some parking validation cards that you can pick up if you parked here at this building. I want to acknowledge Anna Mae Anderson, who played on the harp as we were coming in. She does a beautiful job. We really appreciate her bringing her harp here and playing for us. And we'll be hearing from her again a little bit later. Before we begin and have an opening prayer and blessing on the food, we were talking about just what's bringing us together is the beginning of a new family. Jamie and Ben have started a brand new family today, an eternal family. And so later, after we've all had a chance to eat, we're going to ask somebody from each family here to introduce your family. And I'd like you to be thinking as you eat about something that your family does that you enjoy doing together as a family. So when you introduce your family, you can share something like that with us if you'd like. And that's maybe just a way to get to know each other a little bit better and also give Jamie and Ben some ideas of some things that they'll want to do in their family. We've asked Cheryl Jorgensen, Ben's stepfather, to give the opening prayer and the blessing on the food. And after that, our dinner will be served.
Wave.
Congratulations, Jamie.
Do it again, Amanda.
It's like the monkey hands. Yeah. Monkey brain.
What?
Hey, Grandma, give us a smile.
Thank you.
in, we'll have each family introduce their family. We'll begin with Margaret is going to introduce her family. And Anita and I will introduce our family, and then we'll go from table to table so that somebody from each family can introduce themselves. And as I said before, we'd like to invite you to say something about your family that you like or something that you'd like to do with your family. And it's all about celebrating our families. So with that, we'll begin with that.
Thank you everyone for coming. We're glad you could be here to celebrate with us today. I'm going to introduce my family to tell you something that we enjoy about things to do together. This is my mother, Margaret Jorgensen, and my stepdad, Cheryl Jorgensen, and my grandmother, Patricia Stratt, is over there. Something I love about our family is that every time we get together, even though it's not often enough, we always laugh really hard. We always have a really good time together. Enjoy each other's company. That's something I really love about it.
Okay. I also want to thank everybody for coming. I can't believe how many people there are. And I want to introduce my parents. This is my mom, Anita, my dad, Brad, and my grandma, Grandma Shaw. That's very good. And something, one of the things I love to do with my family is my brothers write music and play guitar and stuff. And this summer we went on a family vacation and we stayed in the place that had an organ and my brothers had their guitar and so Sean wrote a song and they would all sing it together. It was just a lot of fun. When we first met Jamie,
we had just, Cheryl and I flown in a couple of years ago here for Margo's graduation from law school, and it was so late at night, and we wanted to just go to bed. And about midnight, they called from Provo saying, but this is the only chance that Jane is going to have to meet you, because she goes, flies out tomorrow to go to her brother's wedding, and if we don't meet her tonight, you won't get to meet her. And so, at 1 o'clock in the morning, they show up at our hotel room, and we're trying to, you know, stay awake. And in Michigan, we know we have 2 hours difference in time, and so we said hello, and 20 minutes after we all met, we were all starting to fall asleep. So within 20 minutes, Jamie was in bed with Grandma in one bed, her husband and I in the other bed. Benjamin was sleeping on the floor under the window. And so I figured if Jamie could fit in that well to our family that quickly, she had to be the right one for him. And I'm glad that they decided that that was true, because we just love Jamie. We are so glad to have met a whole other family. You are just delightful, and we're looking forward to having many years of a very special family reunion. Thank you.
Okay, so our family is great. He's our oldest son. Is our family. And then Jamie and Jenna and Sean, Andrew, Guga, and Sam. That's a family. And something that we all love to do in our family, well, some of us don't like it, but when we have scriptures or family home meeting or things like that, we like really go off on tangents, and it takes like hours, and I really like that, because they're just so cute. But that's not the internet, right? We like
them. Sam also, he's our 6-year-old, he also wanted to say that he likes to play catch. And I also wanted to mention one thing. I'm not sure if Ben knows this or not, but the semester before Jamie went up to BYU and met Ben, she asked me for Father's blessing, and she was concerned at the time about friendships, boys, just all of that, you know, not knowing how her life was going to go. And I remember being inspired to bless her that she would meet somebody up at school that would be very special. And I don't remember the words that I used, but I remember that I was kind of amazed that I was prompted to say that. And so as Jamie and Ben have been getting to know each other for a while now, I at least, I think Jamie forgot about that, but I always kind of held that in the back of my mind as something that let me know that Ben is a very special person, and that Jamie and Ben were directed to each other, to meet each other, and to create this family under Heavenly Father's direction. And I'm grateful to, we're grateful for Ben to be part of our family, and for all of the Danas and Jorgensens, all of you, to be here and to have our families welcome together. Why don't we, Brady, if you want to introduce Annalisa formally, and then we can just go from table to table. If you want, you can come to the microphone or just talk about it.
Okay, well, I'm Brady Wiggins. This is my wife, Annalisa, and we like to cook Indian food. It keeps Jamie and Ben coming over to our house, so that's what we like to do.
Hi, my name is Kelly Lopez, and I am a
got our supper on. Hi, I'm Megan Boyce, and Michelle is from. And what I know, Jamie, she's really good. So, one thing my family likes to do is play cards together.
Said he wanted to do it, but now he's chicken out. I am Brad's little brother. And my wife Sharon, and Brandon, daughter Jennifer. And we like to go camping together and ride our ATVs together. My name's John.
I'm Ross Murray. Jason, and Lindsay had to leave, Riley, and Quincy. Something that we like to do as a family, we've always liked to go on little adventures, like for hikes and walks and to see different places. And as the kids have gotten older, they don't like that anymore. They like to travel together. So now it's a little more expensive, but we like to be going
Shaws, John and Mary, and our daughter Julie, and this is our favorite mom of all, and my sister Kathy over here, and Erin and Katie, her daughter, and Jane Wiggins is with us at our table as well. We've had a lot of opportunities to have wonderful family times together, right, from the times that we've been around the campfire at our farm up in Ogden Valley, listening to old Ephraim stories that go on and on. In fact, when Mary and I got engaged, we came back to the family gathering at the fireplace, and she was trying to show off her new wedding ring, new engagement ring and everything. And Dad just kept going on and on and on with the story. So we come from a long history of that. Anyway, but from having Jamie and her family, kids over for jet skiing or getting together for family and gatherings, that has always been a wonderful thing. And I can tell Dad that your family is much the same. So we're delighted to be able to come up and share this time with you.
Well, I take a lot of responsibility for this occasion because without me, Jamie wouldn't be here. I bought my family to stand up, the members of my family. My son John, his wife Mary, Anita Wiggins. Where are the rest of them?
I have
the headquarters, Sandy, Aaron, Rosemary, and Kathy, and her girls. And I just like to say that we have done some wonderful things as a family, some good things, also some interesting things. Those of you who know Anita know that the hardest work she does all day is get out of bed in the morning. And in order to get her out, her dad started garbage day. And what he did, he'd wake everyone up and he'd say, "It's garbage day, it's a garbage day." And they would go get the wastebasket in her room and come down the steps and we'd all throw the garbage into the big can. One time Kathy got started a flag, an American flag, and a record of the Stars and Stripes Forever. And so our garbage days were not just my runs. We had the music and we kept in step. And we had a great family experience.
Well, I'm the only one of my immediate family that's here. But because I raised independent children and they've all kind of just I'm Eunice Ann, and my husband is Brad's oldest brother. And one thing that I remember so much about Jamie is her very special relationship with Grandma Eunice. And but it. It was very, very obvious. It was a very obvious connection. And but Jamie's a very, very special girl. And I just remember so much all those little campouts and how much fun we had. And the one thing that our family really enjoys doing is we manage to come together at least one time a year. And we usually have one great big family party at Christmas time. We try to have more than one during the year, but that one is can never be changed. That one always has to be there, and so we get together and just eat and have fun together. And I suppose my grandkids rotten, which is probably not great, but it's fun.
Well, I've been introduced twice, so I didn't think I had to stand up. But if you say so, Brad, I'll do whatever. I'm Nita's sister, Kathy, and these are my daughters, Erin and Katie. And we do bubbles in our house. We do bubbles for all different occasions. So, Jamie, thanks for getting married so we can have bubbles for dinner. That's amazing. We love to do a lot of things. But one tradition that we've had forever that we love is we always go up to the Park City Art Festival, save our money all year long, and so we'll enjoy that. We like that.
Mom. Brett and Nina were our first landlords as a young married couple. When we moved to Virginia, they rented us their basement. But they not only were landlords, but they were mentors to us and set a great example for us that we have followed, or attempted to follow in many ways. Nan and I remember fondly their enthusiasm for life, especially Nita. She never let the number of children they had get her down in terms of seeing all the cultural events and taking advantage of all the opportunities there were in Washington, D.C. She would take the kids to the Smithsonian and drive by the Lincoln Memorial and look back at the kids and point it out to the kids. She loves life, and her enthusiasm is contagious. One of the, so probably anything neat that we do with our kids, we have Brad and Nita. But one thing that we do that our kids have had a lot of fun with is compiling family photos and then laminating it into a placemat. And so when we sit at the table, we can look at vacations and see friends. And that's been kind of a neat thing. The other thing that our kids like to do is draw on plastic plates pictures, and then we use those plates and pass them around at dinner time. Yeah. But anyway, it's a pleasure to be here. We really love the Wiggins.
We're the Andersons, Dave Anderson and my wife Laurelee, and our oldest daughter Anime, and our son Adam. We have several others, but we, Brad and Anita and their family was our family away from home. We were in Virginia also, knew Carl and Ann, but we had a lot of fun in Virginia. We were going to school there, and they were our family. Our kids played together. Got ears pierced together, did all sorts of things together and had fun. We served in church callings together. Just have a great deal of love and respect for the Wiggins family, Brad and Anita and their children. One thing, our family likes to do is we have several traditions. We like to we build on those. At Christmas time, all the kids, even to this day, still like to sleep in the same room together, and we build a big Christmas fortress and out of blankets and a big tent, and everybody sleeps in the same underneath the big tent. And that's kind of on Christmas Eve. That's kind of cool. And then we have a model going on that we love to play games, most of us, and our motto is that every game can be improved upon. So one of these days we'll write a book, I think, about Anderson rules to gaming and change all the rules and make them better. But anyway, that's what we usually do.
Yeah,
Okay, great. Before we do that, I understand that Tuesday was the Maid of Honor Jana Wiggins' birthday, and yesterday was the Best Man Kimball's birthday. So we got to sing happy birthday to Jana and Kimball. So, let's do that now.
Thank you.
more things in our program. We'd like to hear again from Anna Anderson, Jamie's friend from way back in Virginia, playing on the harp, First Arabesque by Debussy. And after she is finished, we'll have a slideshow of some of the pictures of Jamie and Ben over the years. And then after that, everybody's free to mingle and just finish up our enjoyable time together. Thank you again to everybody for your efforts to be here.
Thank you.
Let's also applaud for the staff here, the good job that you've done here.